Welcome. I wanted to just pop on here live since it's been a while and share some things about sort of what's going on and some energetic support perhaps. So, you know, if you've been following me on here on either on Instagram or YouTube or Facebook or wherever, you're aware that have a book out, Becoming an Empowered Empath. I have a new event coming out with the Shift Network, and you know, just here to offer you some energetic support. So first of all, I wanted to share that, you know, one of the common questions that come up when people ask me about, you know, how do you stop taking on energy of others? And if I'm so empathic and I'm sensitive, and certainly through the pandemic year where it's increased, and with everything that's going on in the world right now. So one piece I wanted to just really highlight is that, you know, our energetic body, we take in a lot of energy from the waist down through life, through the ether, through, you know, through the collective. And it's very hard to process energy through your body that isn't yours to begin with. And while many of us may know that on that sort of, you know, current day level, you know, I'm taking in all this energy and it's just too much, it's overwhelming, I have to come back to my center. The question can go a little bit deeper in that, how deep do we want to go in terms of how much energy we're holding in our body that isn't ours to begin with, going back through time? And what that has us do is look at our blind spots. It has us look at the pockets and places in our energetic system, specifically the lower body, and why we're carrying energy, or how we've absorbed that energy into our body, because we had to, because it was part of survival, because it was part of bonding and attachment in our family system or in the world. So what's interesting is that people, we are, you know, very, very sensitive. I mean, whether people identify as an empath or not right now, everybody's feeling something empathically. It's that type of temperature in the world right now. We have that type of, you know, sort of astrological forces happening at the same time. And so I really invite you to sit with the question inside yourself, is this mine? Is this mine? And it's such a simple question to ask. It's a common question to ask. But really, truly, sitting with yourself and grounding powerfully into your body and inviting the current energy to release, you know, sending it back, you know, detoxing your field. Maybe it's about even taking your hands and moving the energy out of your body. Maybe it's going to be a salt bath. Maybe it's going to be a walk out in nature. You know, maybe it's movement, dance, yoga, something that's going to sort of move the body a little bit. And that will help with the energy on the collective and on the peripheral level. And then we've got that deeper energy. Was it mine to begin with? And that takes us into a deeper healing process. I keep talking a lot about the masculine and feminine energy in our system because it's sneaky. It's not, we think of feminine, you know, as a feminine energy as related to gender and womanly, and yet everybody has feminine energy no matter the gender. Masculine, we apply gender to it. And the qualities of masculine and feminine energy exist in every human being. They are the qualities of intuition. Feminine energy is being in tune with people and ourselves and what's going on, and being able to be vulnerable and connectable and sensitive and just having heart. Those are qualities of feminine energy. And qualities of our masculine energy is being productive and having that sort of rationale, problem solving way of thinking, and also manifesting our true self in the world. We haven't, you know, we need the masculine energy to put ourselves out there in the world. We need that oomph, that fire in the gut, fire in the belly. Well, what happens in our system is that we as a, you know, as a big collective, a societal ingrained in our deep blind spots and our subconscious is the awareness that our feminine is shame worthy. It's like the feminine in us isn't as powerful or strong as the masculine. We have to toughen up. We can't have our emotions. We have to think rationally. We have to be analytical. We have to succeed in all of these ways that are expected of us, but they don't have to do with our creative side. I mean, that's conditioning that's come through time. And the reason I'm bringing this up is because so much of what wasn't ours to begin with that might be triggered now in the collective, so much of that is old energy. You know, the imprinting that we absorbed into the pelvis, believe it or not, the tailbone, believe it or not, the lower, the belly, that we hold so much old conditioning about who we are and more importantly, who we're not. And that energy is the energy that we need to start diving into and clearing, because part of it is that the feminine that is rising that we see on that collective level is actually for many people their intuition inside. My intuitive, my true self, my integrated self, my power, my calling, my light, that's our feminine energy. So that energy is emerging and it really can't, it's not working with the wounds anymore. It's disagreeing with the wounds in our body. And so it's pushing through, bringing our wounded energy to the surface, our old unhealed parts to the surface. And a lot of that is energy that was not ours to begin with. So it's hard to process. Our belly will not digest energy that was not ours to begin with. So it's our job to clear that energy, to keep working with it. So I hope this helps you. I want to give you just a moment to breathe into your belly and remind you, take some time to keep tuning into your body. I'm releasing what isn't mine, what wasn't mine to begin with. Tomorrow, I'm going to be offering a talk through the Shift Network. I do a longer guided meditation. It actually happened this past week on Wednesday. There's an encore tomorrow. The information, if you're watching this on Instagram, is in my bio. It's with the Shift Network, and we'll post the link if you're watching this on Facebook or somewhere else, YouTube. We'll post the link below. But take care of yourself right now. Truly keep breathing in and exhaling out and allowing your conscious awareness to say, I'm letting go of energy that was not mine to begin with, no matter how far back it goes. Keep working with that. And that will help you with resilience amidst all that's going on in the world today. Okay, many blessings, lots of love. Hello, everyone. Good to see you all saying hello. And we'll be in touch.